Hey everybody! Sorry production on this video was delayed a bit, but the people who support me on Patreon got to see previews of it and some of the other figures I'm already working on. If you want to join them, all you gotta do is support me. The link is in the description below. Hello out there, this is Wake Angel 2001, pretty much recovered from New York Comic Con, and I'm coming at you with a commission for Pawniard11. It is Silver Sonic, or Mecha Sonic, whichever title you prefer. You know, the penultimate boss from Sonic 2. Also, the Game Gear version of Mecha Sonic made a cameo in Sonic Mania, just thought I'd mention that. So, Mecha Sonic, partly to scale with the regular 3-inch Sonic figures, is made out of the Jazzwares 4-inch Classic Sonic. Dismantling this figure is pretty easy once you put it in the boiling water, but I should warn you that once removed, reattaching this guy's head is extremely difficult. The neck peg is very thick, and it doesn't want to go back inside the small head hole, and heating up the head is a very large, hollow piece of vinyl, so softening the head up enough that you can put the neck peg in can also cause you to accidentally mush it out of shape. I found that out the hard way. I actually had to poke a hole in the side of the head in order to allow air to enter back into it so it could be round again, because attaching it to the head caused it to squash. Remember that episode of Bob's Burgers where they accidentally melted the accidentally melted her doll in the oven, and they tried to fix it with a heat gun and made it all mushy? Yeah, that's what this thing's head looked like before I reinflated it. So yeah, be careful. Aside from attaching a few nuts and bolts to the head, like I said, it's hollow, so you can't really cut into it, because then you'll just compromise its integrity. All the sculpting is on the body. So as you can see, the legs have those really big shin things and some wheels. The body has that really huge thing on the chest to look like the squared off armor, as well as a pole I put in there to make it look like the hydraulic line. And of course, the forearms are beefed up with quite a bit of armor as well. I even put some armor on the shoulders, although you have to be very careful at least on clearance, or else you can, you know, limit your figure's poseability, and you don't want that. So the sculpting is all pretty simple, like nothing you really had to majorly take apart in order to do so, but there is a trick to the paint job that I want to show you right now. Silver Sonic basically has two levels of metal. There's going to be the outer layer, which is his armor, it's all gleaming and polished, and then there's going to be his inner layer, it's like his mechanical componenture. This is going to be the darker, greasier metal, because it's covered with lubricant oils and stuff. Now, of course, I can't really go into all the fine detailing here, I mean, it just wouldn't match the style, although I imagine some third-party company might put a whole bunch of wires and gear greeble and stuff to capture the effect. But the really simple way to do it is like this. As you can see, first I painted a black layer on all the parts that are going to be the internal components. Then, on the outer components, I painted it all gray. Once all this is dry, all you gotta do is put everything silver. Put silver over everything. All the parts that you previously painted gray will come out looking all shiny and gleaming, and then the parts that you painted black previously will look a little streakier and darker. This is a perfect way to quickly match the two textures of metal for the figure. So let's get to reassembling him and see how this pays off. That Cylon-esque mono eye just looks so cool. But yeah, that is the completed Silver Sonic / Mecha Sonic. Again, whichever title you prefer to call him by. I do not have a boat. I do not have a dog in the fight. Wait, do I want to use that metaphor? I don't know. That's not the hill that I'm going to die on. That's a better metaphor. Unfortunately, because like I said, the head is a giant hollow piece of vinyl, I can't reconfigure the spines to be the single row of sharp blades, which is typically how he's depicted in the original game. But you know, this looks pretty good too. I think it looks enough like him from profile at least, and I like it. It looks, I really do like the way that Silver Sonic looks. He's just kind of awesome. I just wish that this figure had knee joints, but the only classic Sonic to ever have knees was the massive 10-inch one, and I never got that one, and I kind of regret that decision to this day. But that's besides the point. Hopefully I'll have more customs complete very soon. In the meantime, I'm signing off.